Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about common problems and reliability issues with the Subaru WRX. The WRX has been in production for 30 plus years now, and so it has used a number of different engines. There have been 5 different engines used in the WRX, and 6 different engines if we include the STI in that number. However, one thing has remained constant across all 6 variations of these engines, and that is that the WRX and the STI are 4-cylinder turbocharged engines. Of course, it's difficult to discuss specific problems when we're talking about 6 different engines over a 30 plus year period of time. So for specific engines, we will have individual problem and reliability guides, but there have been a number of shared problems across all the different WRX engines. And so in this video, we're going to talk about a couple of those high level shared problems that all WRXs and the STI have in common. I'll do my best to denote which engines these predominantly affect, since there are a couple problems specific to the older models and some specific to the newer models. With that being said, the first problem with the WRX is with the engine's internals. Now, of course, the WRX is a popular car to modify, and unfortunately, its weakness does come down to some of its internal components. Now, this is predominantly true for the newer 2004 plus models with the EJ255, the EJ257, and the FA20. This is mostly just an issue for modified cars. It doesn't tend to be as much of an issue for the WRX in completely stock form, but once you do start to modify these engines, you start to experience some of the weaknesses of the rods, the rod bearings, the pistons, and the piston rings. So those are the 4 common internal problems that you run into on WRX engines. And again, they commonly happen when you tune and modify these engines. I would say one of the most important things when it comes to a WRX and modifications is proper tuning, because they can be a little bit finicky if you're running a poor tune or you don't have the proper supporting modification setup. And so when it comes to building WRXs, you want to make sure you have all of your supporting mods and that you work with a high quality, reputable tuner to go ahead and get yourself the best tune, because that's the most important thing to help protect your engine's internals. With that being said, most of the different variations of the WRX engines can only handle about 300 to 350 wheel horsepower before you want to start looking at upgrading the internals. 350 wheel horsepower is probably about the safe limit, to where if you start pushing anywhere beyond that, you're going to significantly increase the likelihood of experiencing internal problems. So as fun as these cars are to modify and to drive while modified, they do just have a poor reputation for the strength of the internals. Second problem to talk about is turbocharger failure. While the previous internal issues tended to be with the newer Subaru WRX models, turbocharger failure happens more frequently with the older models, and that's because turbocharger technology has advanced significantly in the last 10, 15, or 20 years, and so turbochargers nowadays typically last about twice as long as these older turbochargers do. And of course, modifications do increase the likelihood of running into turbocharger issues on these older vehicles, but with that being said, they do tend to fail or run into problems around the 100 to 120,000 mile mark, and like I mentioned, on the newer ones, you'll likely be able to see 200 plus thousand miles out of them. It's just one of the things that these older turbochargers weren't quite built the same or as well, and so they experience problems more frequently. So if you own an older WRX, just be aware that turbocharger failure does happen a bit more frequently than you would expect on newer modern vehicles. A third common problem across pretty much all the WRXs is going to be with oil leaks. Now, oil leaks are, of course, a little bit more common on any turbocharged engine because the turbochargers produce a lot of heat, and all of that heat puts a little bit extra wear and tear on things like your gaskets and seals. And so with the WRXs specifically, you tend to run into a lot of issue with valve cover gasket leaks, oil pan gasket leaks, and then there are some small issues with main seal leaks. So ultimately, oil leaks are just part of owning a WRX. Fortunately, the oil leaks tend to be on the smaller side. They're not quite as bad as some of the things that we experience in the BMW world with things like the N54, But oil leaks are likely something that you're gonna run into, especially once you start to get to higher mileage on these WRX engines. And then the last common problem that I'm gonna talk about, fourth on our list here, is issues with the ignition and fueling system. Turbocharged engines tend to run through spark plugs and ignition coils a lot frequently than naturally aspirated engines. So this is really a little bit more of a maintenance related thing and not a problem, so to speak, but just understand that you will have a little bit more frequent maintenance to be done with your ignition system, just because the turbocharged nature tends to wear down on those more quickly. And then lastly, some of these newer WRXs switched from port injection to direct injection. And so with direct injection, tends to come problems with your fuel injectors as well as with carbon buildup. And those just naturally are two things that tend to come with direct injected engines. And so it's just a little bit of an extra maintenance item here as well. Ultimately, your ignition system and your fueling system aren't huge problems on these cars, but because they're turbocharged and because they've now moved to a direct injected fueling system, you're gonna run into slightly more frequent maintenance. So guys, those are the four main problems here that really kind of affect all of the WRXs. As I mentioned, we will have different videos and we do have guides online on all of the different engines that were used in the WRXs where we list out problems that are specific to those. But I really just wanted to cover a video talking about the WRX and the STI as a whole and some of the problems that you tend to run into, and especially that you tend to run into when modified, because of course these are highly and frequently modified cars. While they are fun to modify, you can make some decent power out of them, they do have some weaknesses with the engines themselves that it's important to be aware of before you start throwing thousands and thousands of dollars into upgrades. So at the end of the day, these cars and these engines are both reliable and they're unreliable at the same time. They are reliable in stock form. You're likely not going to run into any issues with internal failures in a completely stock setup, but you still will have some higher maintenance related costs and things to keep an eye out for, like oil leaks, your spark plugs and ignition coils, your turbocharger, as well as your fueling system. And then they are unreliable once we start talking about adding modifications to them. They have a relatively small kind of window of where you can add power, but you can't add too much power. Typically, just some basic bolt-on modifications and tuning can easily push these engines beyond their power capacity. And so that's why I stress the importance of proper tuning for these engines. When the internals do fail, it tends to come from pre-detonation. So it's really important to make sure that you're not running lean or you're experiencing significant timing pulls, as those are gonna be some of the common things that lead to engine failure. And of course, those are things that can be mitigated with proper good tuning. Anyways, guys, I hope this video was helpful on shedding a little bit of light on the Subaru WRX as a platform in total. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel, click the like button, and stay tuned for all the future guides that we do on the individual engines like the EJ255 and 257 that were used in these WRX and STI vehicles.